Hello and welcome to something new from me. Here I am at the Skyrim menu, which implies I am going to be playing Skyrim. So let's start playing Skyrim. I'll probably cut out this loading scene, although I might not. Haven't decided yet. I mean, it is a pretty loading screen. The loading screens in Skyrim are much better than in Fallout 3 in New Vegas. Not that New Vegas really matters because it's a different studio, but you know, it's a similar idea in a way. I mean, there's a lot of crossover. And Skyrim is about to start. That was actually rather a long loading screen. Here are fellow prisoners. I think the story is I was caught sneaking into Skyrim. Like I'm an immigrant or something, and so they're gonna execute me for it because that is the Imperial way.
Hey, you.
Yes, I am. Hello.
You were trying to cross the border.
Apparently so.
Walked right into that Imperial ambush. Same as
yes. Sorry, I was explaining the story because I wasn't entirely sure if the story was explained now or a little bit later. I couldn't remember. I'm not as familiar with Skyrim as I am with Fallout 3. This guy stole a horse.
You there, you and me, we shouldn't be here. It's the Stormcloaks the Empire wants.
Right, I'm just gonna talk over these guys. These guys are all just talking about stuff that doesn't really matter. I'm gonna assume that you're quite familiar with Skyrim. I'll try and explain important things along the way for those of you who aren't, or if you are like only a little bit familiar. But yes, you're probably wondering why I called my video a Derren Brown playthrough. And just in case you're unfamiliar with Derren Brown, I'm going to have to explain Derren Brown. He's like a sort of D or E list celebrity over here, probably even lower than that, maybe H or J, I don't know. But like, yeah, he's like a sort of magician, illusionist, con man. He's terrifying. He can manipulate like people in situations in ways that just don't seem possible and probably aren't. Like that's why I put Conman in there. Like he kind of openly admits to like tricking you, and his shows and the things he does are all extremely interesting and deeply unsettling. And the mystery around him I really enjoy. I think he's a great entertainer and. But like I wanted to focus on the sort of, you know, the kind of like illusion aspect of it, and I just wanted to draw in the crowd from, you know, the people who are fans of Derren Brown and people who are also fans of Skyrim. I'm not entirely sure how much of an intersect there is there, but you know, I thought if I could bring those two people together in this playthrough, that would be a win for the world overall. So basically the character that I'm going to play is like gonna have no direct kills. Like, I believe that Derren Brown would probably kill someone, but he would make them kill themselves. He's that kind of guy, I think. So that's the kind of character I would like to emulate during this playthrough.
Why are we stopping? Why do you think? End of the line. Let's go.
Right, yeah, so I'm about to be executed, but first I have to create my character.
You've got to tell them. We weren't with you. This is a mistake.
Step towards the block when we call your name. One at a time.
Empire loves their damn lists.
Oh. Okay. Oh, I thought this was 100% or not. This guy's Jarl Ulfric. He's the organizer. He's like head of the rebellion in Skyrim. They're trying to gain independence from the Imperials. No, I'm not a rebel. You can't so guess what side I'm gonna be on? Oh yes, this guy tries to run away and unfortunately gets shot by an arrow. Wait, it's very sad. Step forward.
Who are you?
That is a very good question. Who am I? I think Wood Elf. They can command animals to fight for them. Like, that's sort of like their power. Like, each race has like a power. And while I generally quite like being the Argonians just because of how just fucking sexy they look, their power isn't especially useful. They can breathe underwater, but like you're never really required to do much swimming. But yeah, Wood Elf, I think, for this one. Like, they put gender or, like, sex on, like, a sliding scale here, but then just have it as a binary. That's a little cheap. I think we'll just go female, just because of why not. Oh, wait, no, we can't, can we? I don't know. Derren Brown. Female illusionist. Yeah, I don't know. Ugh. Oh, do I have to flip the coin again? I'm gonna have to flip a coin. That means I have to find a coin. I mean, who the hell carries cash anymore? Right. You can't see this. Like, you're a microphone as far as I'm concerned. But, heads. So, male, I guess. Presets. Let's just have a quick look at some of the presets. See if any of them look even remotely like Derren Brown, which I don't think they really do. I'm gonna put a picture of Derren Brown up as well, just so yous know. I don't know. I think that might be the closest. right. I don't care about this. Done. Finish and name my character. As discussed.
Not many wood elves would choose to come alone to Skyrim. Captain, what should we do? He's not on the list.
Forget the list. He goes to the block.
By your orders, Captain. I'm sorry. We'll make sure he remains returned to Valinor. Follow the captain, prisoner.
Well, that's some small consolation. They're going to execute me for no good reason. Like, seemingly just because they don't want to deal with the paperwork. And then they're going to send my body back to, like, my old man. That's...
Ulfric Stormcloak. Some here in Helgen call you a hero.
Is that... is that Colonel Sol Tai from Battlestar Galactica? I don't think I've made that connection before, but he sounds an awful lot like Sol Tai. Like, just by coincidence, I'm rewatching Battlestar Galactica. I was thinking I might do a video about it. And yeah, his voice sounds exactly like it. I'll look that up. I'll let you know sort of at the end of the episode if that's the case or not. Oh dear god, being executed has never been so boring. Like, seriously, fuck's sake, get on with it. They gotta, like, fucking do paperwork and then bless us so that our, like, the gods will accept our souls or whatever.
My ancestors are smiling at me and you say the same.
Yeah, the Imperial flag looks a bit foreboding as well. Or is that the Skyrim flag, or is that just a local flag, or... I don't know, it looks kind of like a funeral, is all I'm saying.
As fearless in death as he was in...
Thank you, Stormcloak fan. Racist.
Here it is again. Did you hear that?
I said, next prisoner!
To the block, prisoner. Nice and easy.
Dragons didn't exist, and now they do exist, and that's kind of the instigator for a lot of the stuff that's going to happen in the game, especially like the main thrust of the game, which is about figuring out why the dragons are back and putting a stop to that. I already hinted at like the Civil War storyline, which was kind of underway beforehand, so yeah, like just like take a nice jaunty stroll over here. My vision hasn't come back properly. Like, I was blasted by the dragon ward and it's now a bit blurry and it's not coming back. Oh, there we go. Yeah, good. That took a lot longer than it should have. Yeah, I'm gonna run away from them. So, I knew that was gonna happen, but I wanted to act surprised. I totally knew that was gonna happen. Ow. Oh, I can't pick up that beer. Or ale or whatever. Oh, my hands are bound. Oh, I can't do looting. Oh, my life is ruined. Here, you, free me. I think he frees me. Should probably get out of the way of the fire there. Yeah. Good call. I mean, I think I said that first. So, fuck you. Yeah, I was gonna. Oh, that guy's dead. Was he trying to eat that guy or what? Did he just fail to eat that guy? Hands are still down. Yeah. Oh, hey, look at my hands. They're completely not bound now that I was knocked to the floor. Right, yeah, I think I have to run with this guy. At least for now. Yes, in fact, right this second I get to make a choice. About if I will join the Stormcloaks or the Imperials. I can't actually imagine why you would join the Imperials after they just threatened to execute you. Yeah, yeah, I think we should get inside. Oh wow, you automatically go inside. You can't just wait there to be burned to death by the dragon. That's a... I don't know. That's very Bethesda. You've got complete freedom, but goddamn, we won't let you kill your dog or die from fire. Hello. Do I have my arms yet? No, my hands are bound. Unbound my hands. You, wench.
Looks like we're the only ones who made it.
That is a shame.
That thing was a dragon. No
yep.
Doubt.
I got like that. The dragon. Breathing the fire. Ruining the town. The dragon. End times.
We better get moving. Come here. Let me see if I can get those bindings. May as well take Gunyar's gear.
Yep, I will do that. And I also the tankard and the brim and this lantern because it isn't glued down. The early parts of this game are probably going to be quite hard until I get the required magics. I am still going to try and do it without any direct kills, and unfortunately it feels a little like cheating having the companion do it, but such is life. Okay, I have healing. Okay, that's good. And I also have flames. Command animal.
No way to get the charts.
Oh yeah, I think that was a command animal spell that I just cast there by, kind of by accident. I don't like the way I set that up. No. Right, good. Hi, come get me. Okay, they're dead. Excellent. Just loot their stuff. A trail of naked bodies. Yeah, the Imperial armor is actually better. I hope that's not confusing for Hodvor here. No, not Hodvor. Is Hodvor the other guy? Okay, Rolaf. I just did some looting in the back room there, but now I'm gonna go the way that Rolaf. Rolaf, see. Yes, that sounds like a very good idea, Rolaf. Let's get out of here before the whole dragon brings the keep down in our head. That's more or less the exact words that he just said, but it wasn't exactly, so it probably isn't as funny. Hello, come get me, I'm a powerful magician. So, call up you now. Oh no, no, I didn't want to close you out here. Good, yes. make the handle so hot they can't touch the door. I'm gonna assume that's what's happening there. Cool. I'm probably going to get like over encumbered pretty soon, but yeah. Potions, various potions. Let's see who wins this fight. Okay, good. Stormcloak buddies! Torturer's assistant. Jesus, why do you need an assistant to torture people?
Wait a second. Looks like there's something in this.
Lock picking. That is a thing that I will be doing. And it's also a good time to explain how like skills work in this game. Basically, skills get better the more you use them. Like, it's not like in Fallout where you get points to put into certain skills. You know. But, and in some ways, I think this is a little less interesting. It means you can't force your character to be specialized. It just sort of, like, because things will just happen. More naked bodies. Like, you see, like, I've got like half a level from picking two locks. Like half a lock pick level, and then your overall level increases when you have like increased other levels. Like, when you've increased your skill levels, then your overall level increases sort of randomly, and like you need to do more skills for each new like character level, Yeah. So like you will event you like you if you're only using like a few skills, it will eventually sort of max out. But then you can sort of reset your skills if you want. So I mean, yeah, I might get into that a bit further down the road when if that becomes relevant. Left an awful lot of gold on these skeletons, you know. You torture people and you take their clothes away, but you leave their gold. It's a little strange, really. You'd think, you know, you'd want to steal their gold and then buy things with it from companies that they disapprove of, you know, just to torture them. Okay, I now have a small army following me. I'm not even really sure where these other two Stormcloak guys came from, but yeah, they're here. Okay, she might die. Okay, good. I put the oil on fire. I don't consider that to be direct kills. I consider that indirect. I also burned my allies to death and that as well. It wasn't a total success, but I think it could have been worse. Are these spiders? These are spiders. Okay. Rolaf, you're up. How much health does Rolaf have, I wonder? I didn't mean to go into third person there. Okay, good. Well done, Rolaf. I hope that I won't be doing that very often, watching from the sidelines. I generally don't use companions. That might change. Like, I mean, if I can't find another way around it, I might, like, recruit somebody. But, I hope that I can try and be a bit more inventive than that. This opening sequence is actually quite good. Once you get past sort of like the was basically a cutscene. Once you get into the keep, it sort of it introduces concepts to you quite well. Like, I mean, there is a lot to cover in this game. Like, there's a lot of base skills. It tries to introduce a lot of them to you while doing this. Like, sort of the magic and then like this the sneaking, sneak attacks is something that it wants me to do, but again, I won't be doing that because that would. Oh shit! Oh shit! A bear doesn't usually wake up, normally I just sort of like crouch but still run past it. I think because I had my magic up.
That was close.
Okay, good. I believe this is me escaping now, or is there another little bit to go? No, there's not. This is the escape. This is essentially escaping Vault 101, but the reveal isn't quite as... It's not quite as good, really. I don't enjoy it as much. Hopefully this loading screen will go away and I can actually show you that reveal. Or I can indeed reveal it to you. Here we go. just a lot of cloud and mountains. Yeah, it's a dragon, you know. But we saw the dragon up close just a minute ago. I don't think that's anything new. There are some ruins on that hill there, I think. Yeah, those are the ones that we'll be going to fairly soon. But they kind of blend into the mountain. You might not notice them to start with, and then it's just sort of like a little trip down the hill for now. Sprinting is a thing. Sprinting replaces VATS, basically. It replaces the VATS button. but it's actually, it's hugely wonderful. I love being able to sprint. Anyway, here we are at the Guardian Stones. Right, so basically, there are three overarching sections of the skills. Like, this blue stuff is all the magic skills. This red stuff is like, well, there's these two things, like enchanting and smithing, which are basically kind of crafting elements. I might go into those some other time. But basically, you've got your warrior skills, which is all your sort of physical direct attacks, which I generally won't be doing. and then there's these sort of like kind of passive skills, like the sort of thief tree, I guess, you know, which includes like sort of sneaking and lockpick and pickpocket. All of these things are things I will probably be doing quite a lot of. I'm going to activate the Thief Stone here, which will boost my experience gained in those skills by, I think it's like 10 or 20%. It's quite a lot, actually. But those Thief skills tend to go up a bit slower anyway, because of the way it works, you know, like magic you're using kind of directly, and I will be using a lot of magic, so I think it'll go up pretty fast anyway. However, I can change that at any time. If I decide that I want to have my magic going up faster for a little while, I can come back here and change that. There are various other stones around around Skyrim. I was going to say around the wasteland there, but no, Skyrim is quite a lush, bountiful place. Yeah, there are other stones like that around. I think one of them like kind of boosts your Kari weight, and the other makes animals friendly to you and things. You know, like they're kind of sort of useful passive skills, but none really as useful as those three. Basically, I'm on my way to Riverwood right now. It's like a little village that Rolaf told me to go to. He told it to me like in passing. You know, I wasn't actually listening. I just know what I'm doing with this part of the game. Like I say, I don't know the game inside out. Later parts of the game, I might be kind of like winging it a bit, which will be fun. I hope. At least I'll be enjoying it. but yeah, here we are. Stamina low. That does actually require, you know, a big sort of screen there stopping the whole action. Like, I have played this game before. Basically, these are the people you talk to if you kind of side with the Imperial guy. However, I didn't. I sided with the Stormcloak guy. And, yeah. New Let's to talk to her.
If you're looking for work, go see Hodder Raylor. How do you know him?
It was Raylor, apparently.
You did? We heard that Ulfric was captured. No, sorry. But in times like these, I can't just take the word of a stranger who wanders into town claiming to be my brother's friend. A dragon? In Helgen? It can't be. Although, it would explain what I saw earlier, flying down the valley from the south.
It would explain the dragon that I saw earlier. Yeah, well done.
I don't know why, but I actually believe you.
Is it because you saw the dragon? Just a flying guess there.
First the war, now dragons. What's this world coming to?
An end.
Needs to know if there's a dragon on the loose. Riverwood is defenseless. We need to get word to Jarl Valgruf in Whiterun to send whatever troops he can. If you'll do that for me, I'll be in your debt.
Okay, so she's told me to go talk to the Jarl of Whiterun. That's a little bit ahead of what I want to do right now. I want to do another sort of small tutorial-ish type thing, which involves going into the shop first. These guys, something was stolen from them, and I've told them I'll go get it back. It's a golden dragon claw ornament, and another sort of thing that'll be fairly important throughout my Skyrim playthrough. So again, I'll get to that in a minute. First, I want to buy things.
Trinkets, odds and ends, that sort of thing.
Or rather, mostly I want to sell things. As you probably noticed, I was basically taking anything that wasn't nailed down. Oh. Yeah, the trading in this game is a lot different as well, and I think it's actually kind of worse. Like in Fallout, you can sort of flick things back and forth quite easily. If you accidentally sell something, you have to go and buy it back, like rather than just sort of have it like all in one menu. It's a little ungood. Oh, I had two of each of those. Okay, that's. Okay, good. That allows me to buy at least one of the books that I want. I want Fury first. Creatures and people up to level 6 will attack anything nearby for 30 seconds. So basically I can start turning people on each other, which is a lot of fun. A little dangerous as well, because like, it frenzies them. If there's no one else nearby, then they're angry at you. You know. He has a couple other useful spells as well, but I'm gonna have to go and get his claw back before I can really afford that. I could steal a bunch of shit, but I don't actually think he'll buy it from me. I think the way that Skyrim works is you have to go sell stolen stuff to the Thieves Guild, or the Thieves Guild. I said thieves. I've always said thieves. I've never said thieves. You have to go sell it to those people, and they're miles away. I forget how this game works. Quest log, yeah, that's what I was looking for. I wanted to activate the Golden Claw instead of Before the Storm, because, yeah, I'd rather not get sidetracked in the wrong direction this early on. I think I have to cross that bridge anyway. Yeah, okay, I mean, I was supposed to cross the bridge and then go up the hill this way. Or not, well, not supposed to exactly, but it's much easier. Generally, the mountains are quite hard to climb unless you're going up the pathways. And here we have our first problem. See, I've frenzied that wolf now and it's just going to chase me. But, hopefully it will chase me into another wolf or other people who will then either be eaten by the wolf or will kill the wolf, thus reducing my problem slightly. Or perhaps I will just outrun the wolf. That's a legitimate strategy as well. Not everything has to die indirectly by my hand. Some things will get to live. See, because I'm like, I'm a nice guy, really. Save. I have to remember to save regularly, because, you know, it only really auto-saves. If I go in and out of my menu, sometimes it'll save. I think it does that kind of like every 10 minutes or so. Fuck off. I thought he'd run inside to his friends who he knew were there. Yeah, I think they're attacking each other, which is more or less what I wanted. Oh dear. Oh, good. I've distracted them, I think. Like I say, it's going to be a little hard to wipe out entire bandit camps for a little while. Probably not too long. I have ideas about how I want to do other things. Here we are coming up to the yeah, these are the ruins that I pointed out earlier. They're crawling with bandits. Also, early on, I gotta be really accurate with my spells, because I don't have enough magicka to just keep casting them. Like, I moved at the last second. You saw that. You all saw that. Oh, fuck off. Okay, I can do that. I forgot I could do that. No! Stop! There we go. Right, frenzy, and please attack the people who were shooting at me, because hopefully they'll be shooting at you as well. Hopefully I've ruined your life. Attack the people you once called friend. Like this guy who just fell off a cliff. No, I'm not as good as dead. Ugh. Fuck off. Thing is, like, if you are nearby, like, those illusion magics are best, like, cast from a position of sneak. Like, because then they'll attack nearby enemies that they've detected. Basically, if not, you have to lead them into other enemies, which I think I finally managed to do. Yes, good. Okay, I think the archers killed her. That's kind of annoying. I'll deal with these on my way out. This is a much less interesting loading screen. Yeah, this is what I was talking about. Oh, did I miss? They were alerted by my spell, but my spell didn't hit them. Oh, why? Increases magicka by 30%, magicka regenerates 50% faster. That's actually much more useful to me than the armor. Generally, I hope not to be attacked physically. Wrong thing. Yeah, okay, nobody noticed that big red spell flying across the map, but they did notice that they're getting shot in the back by archers, hopefully. Come on. Attack each other for sake. That felt a little close. This isn't working the way I want it to. Oh, no, it is. There we go. Yeah, okay, that's good. Okay. Like I say, it hasn't solved my problem completely because there's still one guy standing, but I probably can't sneak past him now that I'm looking at this. I think he's just going to find out where, he's just going to look at me, he's just going to wander up to me and see me standing here with my spells out. Yep, fuck. Oh well. I'm just going to run past his friend and grab lots of stuff. And I'm also going to stop time and lockpick this chest here and get what's ever in that. All looks like good stuff. And now I'm just going to run away. He's actually got quite low health. Follow me, I think. No, wait, don't follow me. Please, let me outrun you. Now that I think about this. Oh no. No, I don't think I can take you. I But yeah, sorry, I didn't want him to run into this guy because I wanted this guy to die. Like, he activated a trap and it went wrong for him. Please stop attacking me. Okay, I have increased my level. However, I want to lead this guy into Skeevers and hopefully have the Skeevers kill this guy because he's annoying me an awful lot. Okay, he's dead now. That is very good news. Right, now I want the giant rats to follow me. Oh, almost. You can see what I'm trying to do here. It's just not working out quite well. It's not like the levers aren't as responsive as that sort of play would require. But I think I finally done it. Pickpocket increase level 21. Right. Level up. This is how leveling up works. You can choose stamina, health, or magicka to advance by, I think it's 10 points per level. And I think most of the time I'm probably going to be health or magicka. Although stamina, obviously that increases the length you can sprint by, but I'm going to need these. I'm going to need some durability and the ability to use lots of magic. Quickly, so I'm going to start by doing magicka. And I also get to spend a perk. And I think I will spend that on Novice Illusion. So it's a half magicka for casting illusion spells. As you saw earlier, it costs me quite a lot to cast my first spell, and this will keep it a bit under more, like a bit more easy. I don't know, like it'll be better for me. I'm just activating flames here because I'm gonna need to break my way through things. And there's a spider. Okay, he's attacking me. Why? I have to. This guy has to die. I need to get something off his body. So, are you coming this way? I'm gonna enrage him, hopefully, run past the spider. Right, go on, spider. Take him out. Good. Fan dabby dozy. Shit, where is he? Where is he? Where is he? Stop moving, spider. Good. Golden claw. All sorts of stuff. Right, I don't need you anymore, spider. Please leave me alone. Okay, just doing a little bit of looting. I'm also going to save before I go down here, because this is another interesting thing about this run. Zombies, which are about to happen, spoiler alert, zombies are resistant to illusion magics. However, they're not resistant to stepping on plates and dying. Oh, works like a charm. Ow. Brilliant. These guys are morons. I mean, I suppose they are, like, zombies, so, I mean, shouldn't expect miracles. But, you know. Yeah, are you coming for some? Where did he even go? Okay. Good. I enjoy. I approve. Damn. He didn't quite die. If I can get this to work maybe just a little better than I did last time. Ah. have him caught up in the explosion as well. Yeah, there we go. Very good. See, you live and learn, but you also die and learn, also. Hello, zombies. Wake up, zombies. Oh shit, why can't I jump? Fuck off. Just want to get past you so I can chase you back into the oil. Nope. Fuck off. Okay, good, right. I did it! Yay! Run through the door. I'm not entirely sure if enemies can follow you through doors. I don't believe they can. I think that's consistent with Fallout 3 as well, but... Nope, wrong. Wrong. I could do sprinting. Oh, okay, good. You coming? Oh, damn. Yes, you're idiots. Brilliant. Good, good. Oh, this guy's dead as well. Over-encumbered. Okay, let's see what I can dump. Right, here's where the golden claws come in. Or no, they're not all golden, but they are all claws. If I can figure out how to examine them, you press in the right stick for your information. You can examine them, and there's like inscriptions on the bottom, like or like with the puzzles earlier, like representations of animals. So like bear, dragonfly, and owl. From top to bottom, and you have to make them correspond to these outer rings, or not the outer rings, but the rings, and then activate the key, because if you do that, if you activate the key before those things are matched up, you tend to get burned or shot with poison arrows or some other awful, awful thing. As I believe I did that right, that shouldn't happen. Good. And here we have a dragon word of power. Now, I can learn the word, but in order to obtain the power, I have to get a dragon soul, which involves murdering a dragon. Which I'll be doing next part by now. I'm going to end this part fairly soon. Yeah, usually there's like a kind of miniature boss in these sort of word of power rooms, and I don't think I can do this right now. I don't see like an indirect way of setting him on fire or anything. Unfortunately, this is gonna have to be like another runaway job, which is a little sad. I do want to sort of like kill things wherever possible, but I just don't want to do it by stabbing them. I also miss out on some loot from that as well. Like, you know, those bosses tend to carry some good loot. Right, just have to work my way back to Riverwood now. Shouldn't be too difficult, but there might be like some random wildlife along the way. Which I can probably command if I use my power properly. I'm not entirely sure what it affects. But wolves and stuff like that, probably. I could probably have used that wolf earlier. If I'd remembered about like the entire reason that I chose to be like a redwood elf. But I didn't. So that will that'll be a revelation for another day, I think. I'm just picking up random flowers and shit now as well. Yeah, I don't need to do anything to her, she's just a poor old woman. Plus I think I can buy some alchemy levels from her later on, if I get like a higher alchemy level. Okay, so those two mages are fighting. I'm just gonna try and not get, I'm detected again. And now I'm hidden. Oh, and now I'm walking off a cliff. Oh dear. Oh. Okay, I'm just sliding down a mountainside. Okay, that was wholly unrealistic. But yeah, not gonna complain. Yeah, the rivers have some like really strong currents in them as well, by the way. Like, yeah, you quite easily get sort of swept down river if you're not really paying attention. Oh, okay, good. Powers can only be used once a day. Okay. Oh, hopefully I'm not gonna fuck this up. That might count as my wolf because I frenzied it. If it starts attacking people, it might be my fault. And then guards might come after me and I might have to pay a fine. Well, it's not my problem right now. It's that lady's problem.
This back where it belongs. I'll never forget this. You've done a great thing for me and my sister.
Excellent. Oh, that's kind of a cool thing to find. Undead up to level 35, entering the circle of flea. Caster heals 20 health per second inside it. I'm not sure if I've used that sort of thing before. Maybe that was like put in a DLC or something. Okay, good. I have a good bunch of gold now, which means I can buy probably most of these spells. But the next most important one is Raise Zombie. Oak Flesh, also very useful, and... yeah, Lesser Ward. Clairvoyance, and Frostbite. Okay, good. I did buy all the spells, and I actually got plenty left over. Buy back those mushrooms because I don't really mean to sell them. Okay, I think I'll call that a part there. Hopefully it won't be too long. I'm actually not entirely sure if there's much that I can edit out of this, but there is bits and pieces, like, you know, some traveling and that, but I think a lot of that was relevant. I was explaining a lot of concepts and stuff. But yeah, I hope this is interesting. Please, as always, let me know what you think, and yeah, have fun.